Your saints, this is Kabianga University, the 18th of November, the year 2017, and finally we are here at Ground Zero, the ground of the InterVarsity National Conference of Youth, InterVarsity, that is, and with me here is Pastor Gilbert, one of the essential key members and key leaders in this particular conference, and I just want to seek his views because preparations have been ongoing here ever since yesterday. Please, Pastor Gilbert, can you give us just a brief on what has been happening here as far as preparations have been arranged? What is happening?
Praise the Lord. My name is Pastor Gilbert. I really bless the Lord so much for this opportunity and this wonderful opportunity that he has given us. As you can see that now we are here, the day is here. We have been here from yesterday preparing for this conference, and you can see that things are in place. The worshippers are here. The PA system is okay. We have been expecting that the Lord may visit this University of Kabianga. Because for a long time, there has been darkness in this place. But we really thank the Lord because of this opportunity that he has given us. Because we know that today, the youth, we are going to receive the counsel from the Lord. We are going to be given the wise counsel. Because the Bible says that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. And so we are here to seek the wisdom of the Lord in this conference. And you can see that we are preparing, things are in place, because now you see the worshippers are in place there. We are going to begin the worship. Any minute from now, the worship is going to begin.
So you are telling us that as far as preparations are concerned, all systems are go. We are ready to begin the conference today.
Yes, please, we are ready to begin the conference. Mm-hmm. The worshippers are in place. The PA system is okay, it's fine-tuned. Everything is in place for this conference. This conference is a very big conference. We are prepared. We have been here actually working day and night to see that this day may come to success.
Yes.
Yes, please.
And one last question. Yes. What are your expectations as far as this conference is concerned?
My expectation out of this conference is that we want the Lord, you know, to bring salvation into our universities, because there is much darkness in the universities. And you see the youth in the universities, they have lost the track because they have lacked the fear of the Lord. But you know that today, the word of the Lord that's going to be spoken here, it is going to give us the direction and it's going to bring light into the universities, so that there may be the fear of the Lord even in the universities. That as the youth in the universities, we may now set our principles right. That as we pursue education and as we pursue our, you know, particular courses, we may also pursue righteousness, we may also pursue holiness, that the Lord may have a place in our hearts.
Thank you. We are receiving many guests, and I see also another representative. Thank you so much, and welcome to Kabianga University. Please tell us, what are your names and where do you come from?
Thank you so much. My name is Vanessa Otieno. I am from Bomet, Moi University Bomet campus.
Moi University Bomet campus. Now, you are just neighbors with Kericho County, and did you come a delegation or you came yourself or a few people, please?
We came as four representatives from Moi University Bomet campus, and we are very happy to be here this morning. It is very mighty already. Even before the service starts, you can just feel the heat here. It is already heated up.
We are still receiving visitors and guests into this particular InterVarsity conference, and I just want to interview the next person. Please introduce yourself to us, and where do you come from?
Okay, my name is Nancy Kogai. I am born again. I am from Masinde Muliro University. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So Masinde Muliro University main campus is represented in this particular conference.
Oh yes.
Okay, now tell us, did you come a team? You came alone? You have a representation? How many people have you come with?
Okay, this is a very rare occasion. I could not manage to come alone. I came with a delegation. We came 25 people. And we really...
people are still coming very massive here in Kabianga University. I just want to sample. Thank you so much and welcome. This is Kabianga University. Amen. Just introduce yourself to us and tell us where you've come from, please.
My name is Brother Gabriel Okoyo from Kisii University.
Kisii University?
Yes.
Main campus?
Main campus, mm-hmm. Yes.
You came alone, you brought a delegation?
We came in a delegation of 11 students.
Okay.
Yes. Uh-huh. To come and partake of this.
I have a representative from Bungoma County, Kibabe University. Please introduce yourself to us.
Okay, I'm Pastor Peter Wafula from Kibabe University Main Campus.
Thank you so much. Now, did you come alone or you brought a delegation to this particular conference?
Yeah, we came some of us. We came four of us from Bungoma.
Praise the Lord. I'm Sister Caroline Waidera from Jaramogi Oginga-Odinga University of Science and Technology. It is the main campus, and actually we are so much blessed to be here. We came a delegation of 20 students, and we are so much blessed to have this opportunity to come in this conference. That actually is the main reason why we are here, is that we may be prepared to enter the most glorious kingdom of God, because actually the Lord remembered us by sending his mightiest prophet of the Lord. If were it not for him, for sure, as students, we wouldn't know where we would have been. And therefore, I thank the Lord so much for this day. Amen.
There you have it, Jaramogi Oginga-Odinga University, also represented in this particular conference. I wanted to sample out some of the institutions that have been represented here. With me here is Pastor Festus Ruto, one of the representatives from Laikipia University main campus. And I just want to ask him, Pastor Festus, welcome so much to Kabianga University.
Thank you very much.
Okay, I wanted to ask you, Pastor Festus.
Yes, please.
You have come all the way from Laikipia University main campus,
yes,
to Kabianga University in Kericho.
Yes.
Tell us, what are your expectations from this particular conference?
Actually, precious people, because of the gravity of what the Lord has been doing in the land, we now see that the Lord has just ventured into the universities now, and he has come to this University of Kabianga in this big conference like this. And now, all the way from Laikipia University, we have come because we realize that for a long time we have been in the night, but now I see a new day has come. And that is why we came all the way from Laikipia, expecting from the Lord. Because this is now revival, because not only Laikipia University is here, not only is the university from Nairobi is here, not only is Kabianga here, when you see almost all the institutions in the land gathered in the name of the Lord because of this conference, then surely we can say that the revival has now entered the universities. And that is why, Pastor, as we assemble here, we are just at the feet of Jesus, that the Lord may now feed us from his throne room as we expect.
And with
from
me, I have a representative from the host county, Kericho County. Please introduce yourself to us and where you come from, please.
Amen. Kwa majina naitwa Damaris Paswa, kutoka Kericho West TTC. Tulikuja jana na wanafunzi watatu, na pia wengine wako njiani wakikuja asubuhi ya leo.
Introducing yourself to us.
Praise the Lord. My name is Darlene Atuta, from Egerton, Njoro main campus, Central Rift region.
Thank you so much. With me here now is Pastor Nelson, the pastor in charge of the youths in the entire Kericho region. And I just want to sample his views on what is happening here today, being the host region of this particular conference. Pastor Nelson, can you just tell us briefly what is happening in Kabianga University today?
Thank you very much, blessed viewers. To begin with, I want to acknowledge the presence of the Lord God Almighty in this very occasion, that from day one when this program was initiated, that we were to have a conference, there was a lot that was in place, there were some logistics that were supposed to be followed, but up to this far I want to give all the glory and all the honor unto the Lord God Almighty, the God of the mightiest end time prophet, for bringing us this far. That as the youths from the entire region of Kericho and the entire nation at large, from the institution far and wide and even beyond the nation, as far as Tanzania, we may gather in Kabianga University, not in any other issue, but in the name of Jesus. I want to appreciate the Lord and appreciate him for sending his mightiest end-time prophet of the Lord, that he came and he brought life and he brought light unto the youths, especially in the university. The so sophisticated university, the university with a lot of issues and things, but right there I am very glad that at this point in time, that is the holy worship unto Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
And with me here is the host pastor, the host of this particular conference, Kabianga University. And I just want to ask him, Pastor Michael Maina, right? Why Kabianga University? Why did that this institution has chosen to host such a mega event in the calendar of the youth church nationally?
So thank you so much. I want to say this is the day we've been waiting for more than 3 months. And finally seeing this event coming to see the light of day. To Kabianga University, it's a new day that the Lord has granted us. And what I want to say is that the Lord has decided to visit this university in a very, very powerful way. Just to keep you posted, for more than 1 week, the university management has been up to speed with what has been happening. Even to shock you, yesterday, the vice chancellor himself, he was on the ground. And even as we speak now, the university chaplain is on the ground waiting for the service to begin. So what I may want to say, the Lord may have loved this university because of the kind of hearts that the university management are manifesting, they are exhibiting before the Lord. And as the host pastor, I know the enemy has pitched tents in the university, even here. But now after this, we are sure the Lord is going to take over and navigate the youth church and navigate the university to the high will of holiness. And this is my hope and my great expectation that Kabianga will go back to the high will of holiness, even as we prepare the way for the glorious coming of the Messiah.
So you are telling us that the entire management of this particular institution, from the vice chancellor, the chaplain, are concerned with this particular event. So what can you tell other institutions, because you are honored to host mega, mighty and other big and other institutions. What is your message, your take home message to other institutions, even as you host them in this particular national conference?
Thank you so much, my interviewer. This is what I want to say. It's not because we merit to host such an event, but just allow me to say this. I know we have many institutions, more than 80 institutions that are going to be represented in this conference, plus many, many, many youths from our altars across the country, and by extension, Tanzania is coming also. So this is my message, precious people, and the youths of the Lord. As we go back to our institutions, let us go and light the fire.
Thank you so much. This is a big big event that is happening right now, and I can see coming is the national correspondent, also the county correspondent in this particular region, Pastor Philip Omondi. Praise the Lord, Pastor Philip.
Amen. Thank you so much, Pastor Arnold.
Thank you so much for having time to be in our interview.
Thank you. This
is a very rare occasion, and it is an inter-varsity conference that is happening in University of Kabianga. You are the host correspondent of this particular county, and you also are the national correspondent in Kenya. Now, you have traveled far and wide, and you have interacted with many people, but I just want to ask you this question. What does this particular institution, this particular inter-varsity conference, portend to the youth in Kenya as a whole?
Thank you so much, Pastor Arnold. I want to thank the Lord God Almighty so much, first of all, for sending us his servant, the mightiest prophet of the Lord, the most glorified prophet of Jehovah. Because as you rightly put it, Pastor Arnold, these are very rare occurrences. And I must say that as the county correspondent of Kericho, I come to thank the Lord so much, because we have seen the fruit, the benefit of his servant being in the land. Because what I can see right now is the revival of the youth church. As you can see, the turnout is so big. Over 8 institutions are here. and many people from across the entire country, and even some coming from as far as the Tanzania border. So this tells you that actually the revival in the youth church in Kericho County has really picked up. And the Bible says that how can a young man keep his way pure? In the book of Isaiah chapter 1, in the book of Psalms chapter 119 verse 10. And you know now the purity that the Bible was talking about with regard to the young people has only seen the light of the day after the advent of the mightiest prophet of the Lord. Because ever since the Lord dispatched him to the nations, he has been consistent and persistent with one single message, the message of righteousness, the message of holiness, and purging sin out of the church. Yes. And now you can see that surely that particular message, that particular effort by the mightiest prophet of the Lord has now brought about the purity in the youth church. Because seeing the youth now gathering in such a big occurrence like this in the name of the Lord, that is really a big achievement. It is a big milestone. And now we see that actually now we can see the light at the end of the tunnel. Now our children have hope. We thank the Lord God Almighty for sending us his servant, the mightiest prophet. Now the youth are not marauding in sexual sin and drunkenness. You see them now smartly dressed, very glorious, people that are focused, the people that are determined, preparing the way for the coming of the Messiah. Now they are turning out to be reasonable people. And therefore we thank the Lord so much. This is very, very big. We give glory to the Lord.
Amen, amen. Just one last question before we release you. What is your message? What can you tell the youth to expect from this conference, even before it begins?
Blessed people, this comes at a very, very important time. A time when the Lord is really showing his signs and wonders in a most spectacular way. The time when now the Lord is revealing his servant, the mightiest prophet, in a very big way. And the time when now the Lord is showing his identity. And now we can see that actually the hand of the Lord is in the land. And therefore this could not have come at a better time than this. And therefore we are expecting that out of this, even the salvation, the fear of the Lord in the lives of the young people of the county of Kericho and the entire nation, and even from the entire region, the East Africa region, will be able to change from today. Because the Lord has given us clear direction. He has given us clear teachings. And we believe that if the youth will be fed in this particular teaching, the foundation brought to us by servant the mightiest prophet, our lives will never remain the same again. So today I believe that the lives of the youth church today will change. Their salvation will go to another level, and the youth church will be at a better position to prepare for the coming of the Messiah.
Amen. Thank you so much, Pastor Philip, the national and county correspondent of Kericho. There you have it. He tells us that we expect a full plate as far as this conference is concerned. I take you now to the conference, even as it begins. Thank you so much.